Cooney is in the artist studio.
From Iowa to Italy and everywhere in between, Des Moines photographer Victoria Herring captures the beauty that surrounds us in her camera. We're in her studio today, and Victoria, thank you so much for letting us come see some of your beautiful images.
Well, thank you.
You're an attorney by profession, but also a photographer. Tell me how you got interested in photography.
Well, my father actually was a photographer, not by profession. He was an attorney also, but his avocation was photography. And so I sort of watched and learned as he did it. And then over the years, I've always taken photos. And back in 2005, I entered a photo in the Des Moines Downtown Partnerships contest and was a finalist. And I thought, oh, this feels really good. And I really like creative things. And so I just started doing photography as a creative outlet, and then did more and more, and started going to art shows. And over the years, I've had awards, and I've gone to art shows, and I've sold photos. And so I find it a really positive creative outlet.
What captures your eye? What do you look for?
I am primarily interested in shooting what we call architectural photography as opposed to landscape. It's not like I don't shoot landscapes, but I find buildings and different kinds of architecture fascinating, and the patterns there and the color and what it says about a culture, etc. If you go over to, for example, overseas to Europe, just the idea of looking at people's laundry hanging out of windows, we all have a thought of what that's about. That's sort of what I like to take, travel photography, some people would call it.
Digital photography? And,
yes.
And what's the process involved with you?
Basically, what you do is you take the picture in the camera on a digital card, and you put it in your reader, and it goes into the computer. And I try not to do much what is called manipulation. Ansel Adams did manipulation. He would burn and dodge pictures and make certain parts lighter or darker. So it's not a new process. Every photographer has done that, whether film or digital. But I try to go in and add what is called levels, which is either black or white to an image. And when you add black or white, it pops the color. You're not getting rid of reds. You're making reds more expressive. And so that's sort of what I do. Sometimes you do other things. You do cropping to get the focal point of the image more interesting.
And what about the final product? On canvas, do you print your own?
I print my own up to about 13 by 19. After that, I have to order it out because I have a great printer, but it's not larger than that. Generally I print it on non-canvas paper. And then there's a new process of printing on canvas, which this printer could do, but I don't do. I order that out. And they also now print on metal. So there's all sorts of different types of printing out there. I can do mine on paper and then order the others.
Are you always with your camera, and are you always looking for the next picture? And what is next for you?
Well, yes, I carry my camera. It's the heaviest part of my luggage, actually. I wish I didn't have to carry it, but I do. I keep it on me all the time. I am doing some shows this summer, so I'm not traveling except for shows, though I use that as a way to get out and take pictures of places. And then we're going to, I hope, take a trip in the fall. And if we do that, we tend to go overseas, and which is not to say you can't find great stuff in this country, but if we have the time, going overseas is fascinating, I think, seeing other cultures. And I personally like the Mediterranean area, so, you know, Turkey, North Africa, and Morocco, you know, Italy, I love Italy. And so there's a lot of things there I haven't even seen yet.
Well, thank you for bringing them to us, for those of us who can't get over there as well. So thank you very much, Victoria. We appreciate it.
Sure, thank you.
Nice to see a little snapshot today. For KCCI, I'm Mollie Cooney in the Artist Studio.
For more on Victoria's photography and upcoming art shows, you can visit her website at www.journeyzing.com. And congratulations.